There's still considerable confusion over the extent of London's ambulance cover tomorrow. Shop stewards representing the 1,800 men and women on the road say there'll be no emergency service. But full-time NUPI officials, the biggest union involved, say privately they expect quite a few of their members to obey the TUC's code of conduct for the seriously ill. And with the aid of the police, the St John's Ambulance Brigade, and those of his staff who do turn up, Chief Ambulance Officer Bob Walton is confident of keeping the service going, provided the public do their bit.
Please, if you really need an ambulance, we will provide one for you. But if you can make your own way to a hospital, please do so.
But can a man who collapses in the street, for example, be sure of prompt treatment?
Well, I would sincerely hope that no one, but no one, dies in this situation. We will endeavour, without doubt, to provide that sort of incident with an ambulance.
The capital's bus crews had already agreed to stop work for 2 hours at noon tomorrow. But this morning, shop stewards discussed plans to extend the protest to 24 hours. Having reached their decision, though, they declined to tell anyone except their own members and ominously advised the public to travel by bike. But late this evening, London Transport were saying they believe the action in central London would be limited to lunchtime. Although LT expect disruption on the tube to be kept to a minimum and commuters should have a relatively normal journey in and out of town by train, the traffic outlook is bleak, with no emergency car parks and Scotland Yard warning that if you park so much as a bicycle on a yellow line, they'll tow it away. Some London schools are also expected to be affected as both teachers as well as caretakers and school dinner ladies either stop work or attend protest rallies. And at County Hall, the 17,000 men and women who belong to the GLC's staff association have been urged not to strike but to take leave so they can attend one of several protest marches planned. In Southend, incidentally, staff at the VAT headquarters there are also expected to walk out. Similar protests are expected from dustmen and other council employees all over the region. But like so much else, the full extent of their action will not be known until tomorrow. Stephen Chambers for Thames News.